She is one of the best-looking game characters from Resident Evil, Jill Valentine. The text generated here looks perfect. Let's understand how to make this using the Qwen Edit model. I am using the GGUF models, but you can use the larger model if you have the VRAM. Links to the files will be shared. The model used here is the Q6 GGUF, and below is the FP8 encoder. The prompt has a lot of details, so you need a better encoder. Next is the VAE, and then the image. This is to adjust the image size, and then it goes to the K-sampler. Above is the prompt, and then the LoRa. This Qwen figure LoRa is the one that does the job. Below is the lightning LoRa to generate the image in 8 steps. The workflow is simple, and you do not need to do much. The image generated is upscaled here. This can be kept as bypassed because the seed here is fixed. If you like the image, then upscale it. Change the seed ID here or make this random to have a different image every time you run. I will add a note here and type the links to all the files so it becomes easy for you to download. So, I think I have added links to all the files used in this workflow. This YouTube link should be the current video's link. Right now, it shows the previous video about style transfer. Next is the Qwen Edit GGUF models, which should display all the models, ranging from 7 GB to 21 GB. This larger model worked on my 16 GB card, so you could try it if you have the memory. Next is the direct download link to the GGUF model used in this video, the Q6 model. This will show you both the encoders. This is the larger 16-bit file, and below is the smaller FP8 file, which I am using in this video. I did not check for the GGUF version of encoders, but this works well in the current workflow. Here is the direct download link, which is more convenient. Next is the VAE download link, and then the LoRa. This is the direct download link to the LoRa, and this is the LoRa page. Below are some instructions I went through, and some Chinese prompts. These are the prompts I have used, and I think I should be adding both to the comfyUI notes. So I have added the link from where you can access the Chinese prompt. Next is this Qwen LoRa. And I have used this file which was uploaded 2 days ago. But I suggest using this image edit LoRa. I have given the download links to LoRa from both categories, which worked in this workflow. This is the upscale model used to upscale the image. Download the file from here, save it inside this folder. If the download fails, you can search for this on the internet. You should get the file somewhere. I have given the prompt I have been using in this workflow, which can be helpful as well. So I am trying the image I used for my channel, and the results are impressive. The image also included the black lines flying, which was to show the fast movement of the ninja in the image I uploaded. The generation time on my 4060 Ti 16 GB was 137 seconds. I also made a video on the nunchaku models. Let me know if you'd like me to make one video on the Qwen Edit Nunchaku version, which should be faster. Upscaling the image took 146 seconds, and the upscaled image looks great. Is that a Samsung monitor? This is the workflow for a Wan 2.2 model I showed in this video. The workflow has now been updated. I have uploaded the image generated just now. The workflow is simple as before. These nodes are to upscale the video and increase the number of frames to make it smoother. I will click Run to cue the workflow. This LoRa key message is due to the LoRa I am using in this workflow. I am using an old 480-pixel Wan 2.1 LoRa, because the results generated using this looks great. You can change it with a new lightning LoRa, but the one I am using works as well. I've also added some nodes to clean the VRAM. I saw this node in some of the other workflows on the internet. I don't know if it works, because comfyUI manages the memory by itself. Let me know if you saw any noticeable difference using the clean VRAM node. The generation time was 300 seconds, and this is the result. It looks good. The upscaled videos are not playable. I will run the upscaled video from comfyUI's output folder. This video is the same 16-frame video generated, but the frames are upscaled. And this video is upscaled and also has double the number of frames from the generated video. Both are upscaled with different frame rates. This looks good and clear. The 32 frames definitely feel smoother. It may not feel to you because the video was recorded at a different frame rate. Make sure to join Discord or follow on Instagram. I will be sharing the results with extra examples on these channels. In the workflow, these are the nodes for you if you do not use the GGUF models. I am using the Q6 models with the older 480 pixel LoRa. I tried using PUSA, but the effect was not noticeable. You can also use Sage Attention to speed up the generation. The increase in speed can be up to 40%. I made videos to set up Sage Attention. Links to the videos will be in the description. Clone the node and place both of them between these nodes. So the model in LoRa goes to the first K sampler, and then the output is then processed again in the second sampler with a low noise model. I am using the Q8 encoder, a larger encoder, because I want the prompt to be as effective as it can be. Below is the image with the resize node. The height and width after resize are the values for the video's resolution. Further in the workflow, here is an upscale model to upscale the 16-frame result. And then the frames are multiplied by 2, which gives a result of 32 frames per second. I tried generating with this image. The character's legs are not visible in the image, but it was generated with a minor flaw in thickness, and a pair of footwear was also added, which looks good. I uploaded the same image into the other workflow and queued the workflow. The generation took 316 seconds, and the low-res video looks fine. This is the 16-frame video, and the text stayed somehow. The letters are fused, which is expected. And this is the 32-frame video. The results with the images will be shared in the Discord group, so you can get the idea. The image used in this example is from the internet, and I have mentioned the same in my older videos. Here is the creator of this image, generated 3 months ago. I will add the notes for all the files so it becomes easier for you to download after having the workflow on your system. And if you are struggling with copy and pasting nodes in comfyUI like this, then press Ctrl and F5 to do a hard refresh. It should work now. So I have added links to all the files and the prompt I used. Hope it becomes simple. If you have ever played these games, you know the drill. Characters are always one step ahead, with explosions, ambushes, and a gun pointed at you. Apparently, even this PVC figure got the memo, so just be aware.